There we go.
Mm-hmm.
Good evening.
Good evening.
And welcome to the March 21st, 2017 Hampton Municipal Budget Committee meeting. We'll call this meeting to order at 7 o'clock. We'll all rise for the Pledge of Allegiance.
Pledge of Allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
I guess we'll introduce some members. You want to start, Ginny?
Ginny Bridle, School Board Representative to the Budget Committee.
David Moore, Budget Committee.
Sonny Kravitz.
Brian Lopham.
Regina Barnes, Board of Selectmen Representative.
I'm Mike Plouffe, Vice Chairman.
Steve Henderson.
Jones.
Bob Ladd, Village District Representative.
Stephen LaBranche.
Very good. I guess we can vote for the chairman and the vice chairman, and I'd like to have the board confirm that we want to keep Mrs. Kravitz for the secretary.
I'd like to nominate Brian for chair.
A nomination for Brian for chair?
And I'd like to nominate Steve LaBranche for chair.
Okay.
I'll nominate Tim Jones for chair.
I second it. Do you have to second him?
We need seconds.
Yeah, I'll second for Steve LaBranche for chair.
So we have Brian in a second, and we have Steve in a second.
Who is the second for Brian?
I am.
I've nominated him. I can't second him.
No.
He's been,
you made the motion.
But we've been seconded.
The board.
Everybody's been seconded.
Right.
So now you're all in.
Well, she needs to write it.
Do you
it
have
down
a second?
Tim Jones, I seconded.
Okay.
Dave
Moore was seconded. I'm in.
You motioned.
I made the motion. Sonny Kravitz.
Why don't I repeat what I have and make sure I've got it right?
Okay.
Mr. Kravitz nominated Mr. Lambert for chair, and Mr. Jones seconded that.
Yeah.
Who was the nominee for Mr. LaBranche? I'm sorry.
I was.
Mr. Ladd
nominated Mr. LaBranche, and Ms. Barnes seconded that. And who nominated Tim?
Steve did. Steve.
And who was the second then?
Mr.
Sorry. Okay, thank you.
Mr. Vice Chairman, if I may inquire, the law on electing the chairman is clear. We must elect a chairman. It says that we can elect any other offices we see fit beyond that. But I think it implies that the chairman must secure a majority of the Budget Committee. So if the Budget Committee is voting, I assume that implies a majority. Mm. We have three candidates, so that may be a challenge. So we may have multiple go-arounds on this.
Ask what the majority means. The stupidity of me asking the question that if you have three people running and you have two and three, wouldn't three be the majority? Or are you saying it has to be the majority of all the people here, that number?
That's how I would interpret it.
You can narrow it down to the two.
Yeah, that's why I'm bringing it up. I believe that we need a majority of the Budget Committee that is voting.
Okay.
And so, given that we have three candidates, that would suggest that it's likely that we may need to have a second vote with perhaps the top two and subsequent rounds. Or even a separate candidate being offered at that time.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So that we're clear on what I think we want to do.
Yeah. Proceed with a vote for Mr. Lapham as chair.
Well, I think maybe we want to hear from the candidates.
Calling the vote.
Well, nobody has said they would not accept it.
No, no, no.
There have been three nominations.
Well, what I'm saying is in the past,
yeah.
It's been a few years since we've had competition.
Right.
The candidates have offered a little peek into how they're going to lead the committee, I guess.
Well, if the board
would probably be appropriate.
We could do that. You might as well start with Brian. And
all I have to say is I've been doing this for 9 years now. I've been through the ups and downs of the budget committee. I started when it was down. I think we can bring it back up again. And that's all I have to say. Thank you.
And then, Steve?
I was asked to perhaps be chair, and I've had, this will be my fifth year on this board. So I think I have enough experience to do it. I've been the treasurer of the Village District for a long time, and I like budgets. I think that I'll agree with Brian that we need to press a reset button with this board, and we need to start stop arguing with other boards. We need to do the job that we're supposed to be doing and not be trying to do somebody else's job. So that's just my opinion. Hopefully, if I'm elected chair, I would like to enforce at least one rule, and that is, in order to keep order, that all conversation goes through the chair. So when the chair, if you have something you want to say, just raise your hand when you recognize that you can speak. Other than that, let democracy, let's let it do its thing, and let's see what happens tonight. Thank you.
You're welcome. And Tim?
I've been on this committee this is my fifth cycle. I've served the last 2 years as the IT subcommittee chairman. I think we did a good job in that space. I think you've noted that when this committee is unfairly attacked, I will step into the void and defend it. But at the same time, I have always advocated that we try to work out issues with other entities. The Selectman's protocol and how to deal with requests for information is a perfect example. I've said over and over again that we need to maintain the protocol that's in the law. We should take the Selectman's protocol as advisory, as a way of preventing interfering with the operations of the town, which is something we have to be sensitive not to interfere with their operations when we're doing our inquiries. But we are, in fact, a separate entity, separately elected, all right? And we need to do the job as the entire board committee sees fit. The implications of Mr. LaBranche's little speech there clearly indicates that he thinks that we are all by ourselves arguing with other boards, and that we have not been unfairly attacked, and for the most part been silent, because those attacks were occurring in our busiest season during the budget season, where we have in fact largely been silent and didn't come out to defend ourselves until our work was done, which I think this committee stands in good stead with the public because of the way we handled what I would classify as unfair assaults on the voters' sovereignty that elects this board to advise them on finance matters. So I think Mr. LaBranch is correct. We do need to do a reset. If I'm elected chair, I will in fact reach out with an olive branch in my hand to town management, the head of the town management, the head of the Board of Selectmen, and see if we can't find common ground to work for the voter being properly advised without all the noise that we have experienced that is mostly unnecessary. And we'll get that cleaned out of the way immediately and come back to this committee with that proposal if we can develop one, or otherwise a report that we couldn't, then we'll have to work it out as a committee on our own. But we must stand firm that we represent the needs for the voter to be advised on finance matters. And we are not going to be sitting back saying, okay, we're at fault, we're arguing, and no one else is. been quite the opposite, in my opinion. So that's the distinction between my candidacy and Ms. LaBranche's. Thank you.
Good.
Call for a vote?
Yep, I'll call for the vote. Everyone in favor of Brian Lapham, say yes. One, two.
Hold on 1 second, please.
Sonny and Brian.
Okay.
I guess we'll call for Stephen LaBranche. All those in favor of Stephen?
Who's the four? Somebody.
Regina.
One, two,
three, four.
Three, four. We got Regina, Ginny, Steve, and Bob.
Yep.
Get them? Yep. And for Tim Jones?
So do we have three? Is that
four.
Right?
Four.
You.
Yeah.
Okay.
So no majority.
No.
All right, so vote again.
Yeah.
Now the vote is on top two. Is that correct?
Yeah.
Thank you.
And we'll take the vote for Stella Branch a second time.
For who?
Stephen LaBranche.
Oh, okay.
One, two, three, four, five.
Hold on. No, I need to get...
Mr. Ladd.
He's voting by.
Mr. LaBranche. Sonny. Regina.
I have Ms. Barnes, Mr. LaBranche, Ms. Bridle, Mr. Kravitz, Mr. Ladd.
Yeah. And then... We'll take a vote for Mr. Jones. This comes over again. One, two, three, four. Plouf, Mora, Henderson, and you voted again, Tim? Yeah. So, Mr.
No, no. How many members do we have here?
We have
10.
11. 10 here.
Yes.
10 here.
Nine voted. I believe Mr. LaBranche, Mr. Lapham abstained.
Yes.
Did you abstain?
Yes.
You're abstaining
On all of this.
All of
the
results.
All of the second time around, you abstained.
Still not a majority.
No.
It's a majority of those voting.
Yeah. No, it's not.
It's 5-4. 9 voted.
No, you would include the extension.
Pardon?
Abstention.
Abstention. I'm sorry.
No.
It's those present and voting or those voting?
Well.
Well, it's 5-4-1 because you abstained.
Yeah, that's
abstained, right.
5-4-1.
Same,
so. So we have no majority in my view.
You know the rule 109.
Well, I mean, majority would be 5-4. That's why you always have an odd number of people.
We have 10 members.
Yeah.
5 is half.
Right.
Not a majority.
You have one member absent.
That's right. Danielle.
It's fact she's absent.
Perhaps we can just hold this vote at our next meeting, Mr. Vice Chairman.
Table till next time, I guess.
We could.
I mean, Stephen should be the chair at this point.
Well, we don't have a full committee.
Well, it's the committee that's here.
I realize quorum. That.
That's all that's needed.
What?
We have a quorum.
We have a quorum, right.
We only have three selectmen, and if two vote to do something and one doesn't, it still passes.
So I'll ask, how was it done in the past? You know, I mean, you've been on the board.
Yes.
So it's not the majority as far as me on that. It's the majority of who's here.
It's the majority. There's a quorum. It's the majority of the people here.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
It's the majority of those who vote.
I think the five carries it.
Well, why don't you move your chair?
Yeah, move your chair.
Yes?
Yes.
Jenny, did the school board meet to appoint a representative to
meeting tomorrow night
this year?
All appointments would be held over until the school board met.
Right, but that was last year's.
All appointments would be held over until the school board meets.
When did they make that decision?
That's what it's always been, Steve.
It's always been that one, okay.
Yes.
We're going to go by, it's always been the majority.
Virginia, you
described, and we're going to go by, it's always been that way.
Okay.
And it's always been, as it will be for a long time to come.
Absolutely, Tim.
That as the total number of elected members of this body decline, that the representation by the governing body appointees will increase,
right,
which is the majority of the votes received by this candidate. And it will always be that way.
Not necessarily.
That the chairman of the budget committee has been decided by the governing body appointees. Yeah.
Tim.
Thank you.
And it will likely always be that way.
Okay, thank you very much.
From now on. It wasn't that way in the past.
Thank you very much. I'd like to ask at this point for nominations for a vice chair. Please. Mr. Henderson?
I nominate Mike Poff.
A second.
Okay. Sonny?
Brian.
Any second for?
A second, Brian.
Okay. So,
sorry, can I have the nominee in the second?
I'm going too fast.
Yeah. Nominee
I've got to learn.
The motion was Henderson's. The second was Ladd. And the vote was unanimous.
Unanimous?
No.
That's just him talking.
It's my crystal ball talking.
We haven't voted yet. Barbara, could you just mention again who the nominees are and who the second?
Well, right now I have Mr. Henderson nominating Mr. Plouffe, Mr. Ladd seconded. Is that right?
No, Ms. Barnes seconded.
I'm sorry. Okay.
I seconded Brian.
Yeah.
Okay, so and who nominated Brian?
Oh, Sonny did.
I didn't hear that nomination, sorry.
And Bob Ladd?
Second.
Right.
Okay. Any other nominations?
I nominate Tim Jones.
No, I don't want it. Thank you very much, so I appreciate it.
All right.
The nominations be closed.
Okay, the nominations are closed. So, are we ready to vote?
Competition requires speeches, right?
All right. Would you like to say something, Mr. Plouffe?
Well, this has been quite a year so far.
Yeah! It certainly started right out.
And it started last summer with Nick Bridle resigning. So the vice chairman has been busy off and on this last year and this year. It's important to have somebody that can step in and to help the chairman with the meetings. There's a lot going on here. The size of the committee over the years has gone from 15 down to, tonight we have 10, we should have 11, is a full committee. It's much easier to handle a smaller group than it is, the larger it gets, the more out of control it can get. And I think that the public has supported downsizing and the public has supported keeping the budget committee. I think perhaps both of those are good things. And I think that if you have the right people, you can make it work. And I've spent a number of years here. I don't particularly like sitting up front. I'd rather sit over there. But I'll sit here as long as I can contribute and help. And that's fine. Thank you.
Okay. Brian, would you like to say something?
As I said at the selectmen's meeting last night, I will ditto that.
Ditto? Good.
That was a mandatory. We had a ditto. I agree with everything you said, and you've been great as the vice chairman. For that, I have no complaints. I have spent a lot of time on this budget, in past budgets, and et cetera, et cetera. And I'd appreciate your vote. Okay?
All right. Thank you, Brian. Are we ready to vote? So, first we'll vote. Those that want to vote for Mr. Plouffe, raise your hand, please.
I'm going to abstain.
Yes, that you can if you want.
Because that's usually what you're supposed to do.
Okay, so we have Steve Henderson, myself, Regina, and Jay. Okay, so that's what?
Four.
Okay. And now for Brian. Okay, so we have David, and Sonny, and Brian. That's three. Oh,
that's four.
That's
one, two, three, four.
Five. Okay, so.
That's four.
Four.
Yeah.
Okay. And so it's 4-4. Jim?
Yes?
You abstaining?
No, I'm not voting.
So let the record show that we have one not voting. So we have a tie.
You could break the tie.
I could.
Yes, you could. You could as well. There's no policy. It's your personal policy not to vote for yourself.
Well, he could break the tie if we revote. I point out that the law does not require us to have a vice chair, and it can certainly be decided at the next meeting as well. There's all kinds of options here.
Or you can withdraw, so.
Or we can do another vote, and it may change.
One of the options, yeah.
It's one of the options. So, I'm going to call for another vote, okay? So, those that would like to see Mr. Plouffe as vice chair, please raise your hands. We're going to end up, I can see, with the same result.
Here we go.
Okay.
I move to make it unanimous.
There we go.
Okay. So now we have...
Hold on.
You can't.
This is for Mr. Plouffe, right?
For Mr. Plouffe. Okay.
Mr. Jones, Mr. Henderson, Mr. LaGrange.
Yes, I did.
Oh, Mr. Barnes.
Ginny.
Yep.
Mr. Bridewessel.
Did you get Mr. Plouffe?
You're voting also?
Yeah, I got my hand up.
Couldn't
get it up off the table, but I got it up.
Wasn't going to vote for you, Mike, until you voted for yourself.
Then I am counting Mr. Jones, Mr. Henderson, Mr. LaBranche, Ms. Barnes, Ms. Bridewessel, and Mr. Plouffe.
That and means. Add Mr. Lapham.
Yeah. Being seven votes.
Okay, unanimous.
I'm Sonny, and okay, it's unanimous. Thank you very much.
Who moved for unanimous? Yes. Mr. Ladd?
No, the motion for unanimous. It was just unanimous.
It's unanimous except for Tim Jones. He doesn't want to vote.
I did vote.
Okay. Wake up. It was unanimous for everybody. Oh,
God. Thank you.
Okay. So, congratulations.
And to you too.
Well, thank you very much. Okay, so next on the agenda is approve the minutes for February 21st.
Move to approve the minutes as written.
I'll second them. Brian.
Okay, moved by Brian. Mr. Jones, seconded by Brian. All those in favor, no changes on them?
I didn't see any mistakes.
Anybody?
I don't.
Okay, all those in favor?
Unanimous.
Unanimous? Thank you very much. All right.
I'm sorry, who was the second?
Me.
Brian.
Move to adjourn.
We have a motion on the floor.
Second, please. Second. Thank you.
Seconded by Brian. All those in favor of adjourning? Raise your hands. No. You're not in favor? Did you have something you wanted to say?
I had a couple
say?
Things I just wanted to go over, but...
Okay.
So. No, well, then I will withdraw my motion. I did not realize that someone wanted to speak on something.
Okay. I'm sorry. Go ahead, Mr.
No, just a couple things. One is, we want to thank the public for coming out and voting. As we all know, it was a real bad day with the storms and everything, so it was nice to see a number of people come out and vote. You know, good luck to all the candidates. Good luck to all the projects that did pass. Hopefully this year we can get the contracts at field for some of the hardest working people in this town to, you know, get a fair contract next year when it comes time to vote. You know, we got our dispatchers, we have secretaries, we got public works people, we got secretaries at the town office. We got a lot of people that aren't at the, you know, high scale of any pay in this town. They get paid fairly, but I believe that they are very worthy of a contract. They're very hard-working individuals, and let's hope that that will pass through. I want to thank Mary Louise for last year for stepping up to the plate when Mr. Bridle resigned for an employment in his new job. She came in when no one else wanted to be part of this committee. I think she worked very hard. She gave a lot of effort. She took over the chair when no one else wanted to be the chair at the time. And I want to thank her for her help on the committee, and I want to also thank her for all her years of service to this town. You know, being on the boards for over probably 40 years between the budget committee and the selectmen, she deserves a an applause and a thank you, you know, because that's a lot of given time. And, you know, I know it's there's some negative points and there's some positive points, but her positive points and her hard work over the years and her love of this town, you know, doesn't go unnoticed. She loves the town of Hampton, and she did the best she could, and I know she always put her heart where it should have been. Last but not least, there was one last thing I wanted to talk about, and it's reference to 91A with the selectmen. I know the article in the paper last week mentioned that you took a 4-1 vote, Regina, to move on beyond that. But I know personally myself, I still haven't got something in writing or an answer, and I believe that when I received the certified letter and I received the letter in the mail, and I got together, I put all my emails together, and I turned them over to the selectmen, as I believe everybody else did here. And I believe at least we deserve a letter to us advising us, you know, what the outcome is. I mean, it did say in the in this article here in the paper, quoted by the attorney for the town, that there was over 50 emails, you know, that expressed opinions, things like this. Well, I can personally say I went through every one of my emails inside out, backwards and frontwards, and I saw one that actually had an issue that related to all of us as a body. That's all I ever saw. So this quote of having 50 or more, you know, I expect an answer for us as a board so we can put it behind us and move on. Because this year, you know, that in-house fighting and arguments and stuff, it's got to go away. We have to get along with the selectmen. We have to work as a team. Because we're here for one reason. We're here for the citizens of the town, and we're here, you know, for the budget. We're here to make sure that it's like living at home and, you know, having your own budget, right? We have to, you know, turn around and do what's in the best interest of the taxpayers and give them the best bang for our buck. So I've kind of gone off a little bit, but if we could just get something in writing to close that out, we can all move on and put that behind us. I greatly appreciate
it. Well, if you let me talk to the town manager and town council this week, I'll get back to you.
I appreciate that. So let's hope for a really good year and that we can all work together as a team.
Anything else?
That's it.
Okay. I'm glad that I'd like to say something as well. I couldn't have said it better, what you just said. And again, a hearty thank you to Mary Louise for all of the work that she's done all of these years. And so the other thing is that Mary Louise called me the other day, and she received a bill from the lawyer. And she gave it to Mike to give to me, and
it was hand-delivered this morning.
Hand-delivered to Mike. Okay, this is a, you may remember, everybody that's here right now was here last year as well. A motion was made. I wasn't here for that particular meeting, but there was a motion made to hire a lawyer. And so Mary Louise went out and retained a lawyer. And so we have a bill here that she just received. I think it was yesterday.
Yeah.
She called me. And so I am going to simply, I wasn't there for the meeting when it was decided to retain a lawyer. I'm going to give this to...
Excuse me, may I see that?
Yes, you may.
Yeah.
I'm going to give it to the selectman rep, and because...
I want you to read it.
Okay.
Not read it out loud.
You'd like
well,
to,
my
you'd
understanding like to read was that money was supposed to be returned because it was only a deposit.
It never was sent.
I don't know for sure.
It was never sent.
I think there are people here that do remember this better than I do.
Always another son.
That there was, she retained a lawyer, there was a contract that she was sent that asked for $2,000.
A retainer.
A retainer of $2,000, and then it stated that it would be an hourly rate of, it was either $250 or $275, and it would, and then that retainer would have to be replenished as the hours were built. And I think it mentioned as well that the, in that contract, that the billable hours would start when he left his office. So if we asked him to come here to talk to us, he's up in Concord, he's going to have 2 hours of driving that's going to be paid for. In any case, my understanding, I might be wrong, was that the Board of Selectmen refused to allow the Budget Committee to hire a lawyer because of a 91A request. They didn't see that as warranted. So they simply said no.
That's not correct.
She didn't have the authority to do what she did. Yeah. Now, there was a letter, I don't remember the lawyer's name. There was correspondence from that lawyer to Mark Drawled saying that there would be no billing if the Budget Committee did not have a way to pay him. He would not bill.
Okay. And Mr. Jones, you have something to say about that?
Yeah, I have a lot to say about this.
Good thing we didn't adjourn.
Well, if we had, we wouldn't be talking about this BS.
I forgot. BS? You mean business?
Yeah.
Okay.
Whatever you want to classify it as. First of all, if we send this as a committee, as you were suggesting, Mr. Chairman, if we hand it over to the selectmen, is that an implicit approval to pay?
It's no, not at all.
So
I would be handing it to the select
and just say deal with
representative
it.
To
deal with it.
Deal with it with the lawyer, our town lawyer.
Right. Right.
Okay, that was my intention.
Right. So we're just pass.
Because I don't
kick the can to, down the road. Pass the buck.
I don't plan to pay for it myself.
Kick the can down the road. Pass the buck. Basically, is what I hear. This was given to us as a committee. All right. And you introduced it as a committee work item, and we need as a committee to work it. We need to say, hey, we're not paying it, or yeah, we recommend paying it.
Okay, is there a motion? Right. Is there a motion in there?
So we just don't hand it off and kick the can down the road to someone else and pass the buck to them and say, here, you take the heat on it. There's a process here. I'm very sensitive to process. You know that. We don't just hand the stuff down and get down to the committee.
All right.
So okay. Please don't interrupt me as you promised you wouldn't do. Now, Regine is correct. There was a subsequent email from this attorney that said he had not planned on billing for the time which he spent largely doing nothing more than speaking about the engagement and drawing up the retainer agreement. And the retainer agreement specified all the terms of that retainer retention of the lawyer. And in that, as I recall, it actually said that until the retainer is the retainer fund has been paid, he will not begin billing until that point in time. And since that fund was never, money was never put in that fund, I had every expectation there would be no bill. So when I saw his email on some email chain that was occurring during the time, I was not surprised at all for him to say, I don't plan on doing a bill. Because it's very consistent with the agreement. So I strongly recommend that, this was, care of Mary Louise Wolseley, chairman, dated March 15th. She wasn't chairman on March 15th. We had an election on March 14th. She wasn't even on the committee.
Could you read the letter?
Yeah, I'll just let you read it. It's not significant. It's just, it's addressed to the Hampton Municipal Budget Committee, Carrie Mary Louise, chairman, dated on March 15th for $427.50.
Hold on.
I mean, for work, hold which on. He didn't do other than, trying to establish a relationship with the Budget Committee, a relationship which was never fully established. So any work he did, as far as I know, was only work toward establishing that relationship, which, again, did not occur. So I move that we recommend to ignore it.
I second that.
Okay. Any discussion? Well, we've got two more people that want to speak.
Why don't you go, Sonny?
Sonny, go ahead.
My understanding of the whole situation was the Board of Selectmen have to approve purchases. Mm-hmm. Okay. Mary Louise shouldn't have signed that letter of engagement without checking with the Board of Selectmen. Right? I believe the attorney said he would forgive the bill because it really didn't do anything. But, you know, let the town attorney deal with the bill. Okay?
Did I get a second? I did get a second, right?
Yeah. Yes.
We have a motion on the floor. Mr. Henderson? Are you done, Sonny? I'm sorry.
Yeah, I'm done.
Okay.
Yeah, I mean, what Regina said is what came out of the discussion. But as a body, you know, we did go along with trying to seek legal representation to assist us with this 91A issue, okay? We did ask for that. And therefore, my reasoning would be is we can't ignore a bill from a lawyer or anybody else, okay? I believe we should, when we have a duty to pass this on to the Board of Selectmen, Regina as a representative, and she takes it forward, okay, and then what Attorney Gerald and the selectmen do at their level. But we have a bill that came to us and came to the town, and I don't think we can just ignore it. Just like if you got a bill to your house, you're not going to ignore it because you're not going to go through collections, ruin your credit, or anything else. So therefore, as a board, I believe we should move it up the chain of command.
Well, you have to actually make a good point, Steve. I have to say that my motion to ignore was in fact the same way as kicking it down the road in a different way, isn't it? So it probably wasn't appropriate. I should have moved to simply refuse to pay it or something like that. But given the...
Would you like to reframe that motion?
I'm thinking about just what to do, and I'm thinking maybe what... I would like some time to revisit the retaining agreement to be sure I'm precise on the dotting of the I's and the T's on this thing that we referenced to earlier. So I would like to just table it, to be honest with you, the next meeting. But I'm strongly going to be saying this committee needs to say something. And I'm like, Steve, you've convinced me. We can't say let's ignore it. But I'm right at the moment saying we should, if we're going to say something tonight, we should say we refuse to pay.
No.
Hold on. Okay. So
we don't owe it by the attorney's own admission. We do not own it.
What I would like to say is to bring closure to the whole process. Mark Giralt should tell us what he found, if he found anything, and it came up. Otherwise, it's too much ado about nothing.
Okay, Bob?
If you recall, I read the job description of what Mark Giralt did.
He's supposed
to advise all the committees. He didn't advise his committee at any point. He simply sent a demand letter for all our emails, which is excessive and unnecessary. And the only way I can accept closure is if he shows us exactly what he found and ends the process. Just because the Board of Selectmen voted 4-1 to close it, doesn't close it as far as I'm concerned.
In that case, I will move, Mr. Chairman, that we give this letter to Regina with our recommendation that it not be paid, and that Regina take it to the appropriate personnel for processing.
Is there a second for that?
Second.
Well, I have a problem with that because it didn't go to the town of Hampton. It went to a chairman of a committee that wasn't the chairman at the time, like you've already
care
said.
Of, though. It was care of. It was sent to the Hampton Municipal Budget Committee, care of.
But I would prefer to table it until I can speak.
My preference, too, but I don't think the body wants to go that way. Yeah. So.
But here's the issue. That date could be a different date. That could be a mistake on their part, you know, with them, what they did. It could be a different date she spoke to them, and they just put that date down. So, you know, okay, why get into technicalities on a date? Maybe it was
April.
Maybe it was March. You know, maybe it was May, you know what I mean? But do we want to go down that road? If we do this, we can move it forward, okay. And let's get it over with.
Hold on just a minute. Okay, first of all, I mentioned this bill, and I mistakenly, and I'm glad that everybody is going to help me out here when I make a mistake, because what I should have done, the will of this board, I'm not here to dictate, so it depends on what this board wishes to do, okay? We still have some more comments. Tim, did you...
I made a motion, and I'm hoping to get a second, to that this committee gives this letter to Regina to send to the appropriate town personnel for further processing with our recommendation to not pay it.
Okay. Would you consider, just for a moment, please, would you consider postponing this, tabling it until the next meeting, I can make copies of that. I can send
email. I would be pleased with that. It'll give me an opportunity to review all of the history on the matter.
That way you'd have a chance to review the history. Yeah. Yeah. Everybody will get a copy of that to be able to see it, and we can talk about it at the next meeting. We don't have to pay this, do anything okay. right tonight.
That could be a mistake from the billing person that didn't know the email that she's that
correct.
The lawyer sent.
It could very well be. So,
why do we have to get everyone involved in this. Well, I mean, I was trying to...
I've got something else I'd like to say.
No, that's all right. And Sonny, just Bob Ladd had his hand up before. He'd like to say something as well.
It was said here tonight that town council has talked to this lawyer and the lawyer was not going to send a bill. So it seems if that was the conversation that was held, another simple phone call by town council to remind this lawyer of that conversation should end it.
Okay. Which was my motion to have Regina send it to the appropriate personnel for processing. That's the processing I had in mind.
And let them make the deal.
Okay, I agree with that. And Sonny, go ahead, please.
Can I add some more confusion?
Go ahead, please.
Okay. We asked Regina, she read the memo from Mark Gerald. The board, the committee asked you to send it on. Okay. We never got it. What came up on the website Friday? On the home page was Mark Gerald's justification. Okay? A big, lengthy...
That's what I read.
No, what you read was
Sonny,
not that.
Sonny, wait.
No,
wait.
Let me finish.
Not on topic.
I'm going to let you finish, but I just want to say we have two issues here that we need to talk about. Right now we're talking about the bill, and I do want to talk about that as well as a separate issue. Okay? So just please wait on that. Let's just stick with the bill for the moment. So... Where are we?
Bob Ladd's suggestion for the processing that I was referring to is exactly right on. Right? Okay. I'm just wording my motion in a way that gives Regina leeway in how it's handled. Okay. That's why I'm saying let Regina take it to the appropriate personnel with our recommendation not to pay it.
Okay. Do we need to take a vote on that or just have the consensus?
I'll need a second or whatever
Brian
you want.
Seconded it.
Okay, Brian seconded it. So anybody else have anything? Your motion is that...
We give the bill to Regina and ask her to send it to the appropriate personnel for further processing with our recommendation not to pay it.
Okay. All right. Seconded by Brian. Any further discussion?
I think you should just add what Bob had said about the discussion between the
two. That's my expectation. I think the whole body's expectation.
I
want to give them a little leeway. Maybe they don't want Gerald to handle it. Maybe they want the town manager to handle it. Don't do that. I don't care.
All right. Yeah. Are you ready to vote? I will point out that what I wanted to do originally was what we're going to end up doing, but I forgot that I'm not a dictator here.
It's not what you're originally doing because we're given a recommendation to not pay. That's the big distinction.
Okay. We have some clarification. Thank you very much. All those in favor of the motion? Those not in favor of the motion? Ginny, Mike Plouffe, Steve Henderson, any abstentions? Do you have that?
Is there an extension?
No abstentions.
Abstention? No. Okay,
so there were three no's.
Three no's.
So the motion passes. Okay. Thank you very much. Now, the second issue has to do with 91A and the lawyer, and I just want to put a suggestion out there. Whatever the will of this committee is, that's what we will do, okay? But I wonder, it seems like watching the selectmen's meeting, and my memory isn't always that crystal clear, so please correct me if I'm wrong. It seems as if the Attorney Gerald said something to the effect of perhaps coming here to this board and giving us some instruction. And at that time, he would bring the instances. I think he mentioned three.
I think you're conflating that a bit. There was suggestion in the oratory that Gerald would see to it that we received appropriate training. There was no suggestion he would personally do that training.
Well, I was thinking that perhaps we could ask Regina to find out if perhaps he could come to the next meeting, which, by the way, is the next regular meeting is on April 18th. If he could possibly come and explain to us what was done wrong.
Can I be get clarity on that?
Yes, go ahead, Tim.
I want to be sure that that meeting with the attorney is not a non-meeting. It's not a non-public meeting, that it's a public meeting on camera.
Okay, and I believe we talked about that yesterday in the beginning about how I believe that, I don't know if we talked about it in a meeting or it was talking to Mark about, because I know Mary Louise had wanted to come in and like look at some emails, but they know, I don't know whether it got scheduled or not, but that Mark made the suggestion that he could perhaps bring that when he came here to go over the 91A.
Right.
Class, well,
Mary Louise is making an individual 91A request.
Right, but they would.
And there was some confusion that she was acting as chairman, and she was not.
Yeah, right. We know, okay? She wasn't. Yeah,
so
didn't think she was.
That's a different track. We're the budget committee.
Right, but this whole conversation happened when we were talking about that. Yeah. What
it was,
what
Mr. Gerald.
Oh, right. Yeah. Okay. I just want to be sure that if we address this meeting as described, but it doesn't necessarily address any 91A requests by individuals.
No, definitely not.
All right, that's all I want to clear up.
Sonny's been waiting very patiently.
I read Mark Giralt's memo on the website, his justification. He left out some important information. The sandwich case, the New Hampshire Municipal Association attorney filed an amicus brief with the court, pointing out that the town being sued was wrong, okay? Mark Giralt didn't mention that at all. He simply tried to justify his 91A request. And I think it'd be nice to have him come to a meeting and tell us all. But if he comes to the meeting, I want to know what he found, okay?
Yes, I want to expand on that just a little bit. I think it's necessary for Mark to come here and give us the examples and show us what was done wrong so we don't make the same mistake again. And I'd like to hear his opinion on how we should proceed in the future. We got into some trouble with sending emails that were CC'd to everybody. And so then there was a discussion about how should it be done, and there was the blind CC.
Right, BCC, the blind CC, okay, is the way you have to.
Was endorsed by the New Hampshire Municipal Association, if I'm correct, but I seem to remember that it wasn't clear for Mark on what he thought the policy should be. So I want to dovetail this into perhaps that we might think about for the May meeting, perhaps asking the New Hampshire Municipal Association, with the selectmen's permission, of course, if they might come here and discuss 91A, discuss emails, procedures, and any other things that this board would like to have discussed at that time. Just for consideration. Is that something that you could
like
take
we did
that
prior
message
years,
back?
Yeah, last year and the
last couple of years.
Right?
Yeah, and so because we don't have a lot to do until really September, in September and October when we get the budget books. So this is the time when we can do some training.
What is the issue we have on the table right now?
We're talking about the 91A. We're talking about Mark Giralt coming here.
Right. So can we deal with that?
I've got another point to make.
Okay, go ahead, Sonny.
Okay. My understanding of the New Hampshire Municipal Association is any elected official can speak to them, okay? The Board of Selectmen, or Mark Giralt and the Board of Selectmen, says only the chair could speak to them. And I find that offensive because we're paying them, what, $17,000 a year so that any elected official can call them and get some advice.
Mr. Chairman, getting into operations and policies is not the place for this committee.
Okay.
And I can't call
Mr. Municipal
attorney either. It goes through my chairman.
That's not true.
As an
elected official, you're allowed to.
Well, that's the policy that's been approved.
Policy.
Point of order, Mr. Chairman.
Yes, Mr. Chairman.
As I asked you and you confirmed, we're discussing the invitation to Mark Giralt to come at our next meeting.
Yes.
Not in May. So may we conclude this issue before proceeding to other also equally important matters.
All right. Sonny, hold on with the New Hampshire Municipal Association. We're going to continue discussing the 91A and Attorney Gerald coming here for April.
Yeah, now that is...
Hold on, Bob. Please, you had your hand up.
On the sandwich decision, it's my understanding, it's a Superior Court decision which has been appealed to the Supreme Court of New Hampshire, has not been heard by the Supreme Court.
Appeal
the Municipal
removed.
Association filed a very interesting amicus brief arguing in favor of the town's right to have these communications. There were all kinds of legal nuances about technology and emails and what constitutes a meeting. So the decision in New Hampshire is still in play. I believe town council's position is until the Supreme Court makes a final decision, he must follow the outcome of the Superior Court decision. That's where he's at.
Okay. Thank you, Bob.
I believe that Mark Gerald's position is, as he stated a few meetings ago, that the appeal has been withdrawn. In any case, all that matters is that we're agreeing, apparently, or not agreeing, to have Mark Gerald come in and address the issue relative to the 91A from the past budget season, issues related to that.
Mm-hmm.
Correct?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And I'm only asking that we also include that it be a public meeting in that we are allowed to ask questions.
Okay.
And the public can hear.
That's okay. Exactly correct. Absolutely.
Okay.
Absolutely.
Do we need a motion?
That is my motion. Do I have a second?
I second it.
Thank you.
Okay. Ginny has seconded that motion. Any further discussion?
Let's hope not.
I'm ready to say yes.
Oh, okay.
No.
Ready to vote? Okay, let's vote. It appears to be unanimous. Thank you very much.
Now, Sonny brought up the topic of the relationship with NHMA.
Yes.
I would suggest, Mr. Chairman, that we may want to address that now.
That's what I was... I have it right here on my list. Is the...
We may want to hire an attorney at some point.
Yeah, okay. So the... I originally mentioned something about perhaps we could ask Regina to see if the selectmen would allow us...
That's baloney.
Well, wait. My understanding is that we have one free training session. Is that correct? Yeah.
Well, why should the budget committee have to ask the board
because
of selectmen if we can
because
have
the training,
association
train No. Because the training, that free training session, is for the board of selectmen.
Can you go hire a lawyer to...
No, I mean, really, when we used to do... I mean, I realized I was there in the dark ages, but the chairman of the budget committee called the municipal association, said they wanted to have a training session, and they came down. Now, maybe that's changed, but why does a budget committee who has a separate thing have to go through the board of selectmen to schedule our training session?
I can address that if you'd like.
Okay. You want to hire a lawyer?
No, I don't want to hire any lawyers. And I think $426, I don't know.
For a couple of phone calls.
$427.50.
Okay. Tim, you want to try to clarify this a little bit, please?
Jenny, as far as I know, the NHMA has never been called in to give a training session until 3 years ago.
Okay. Well, we used to have it all every year.
I'm not aware of that. Did the NHMA came in and gave a training session?
Yep.
Okay.
Too late.
Not aware of that.
A lady and a man.
But when they came in 3 years ago, at my request, because there was a motion at the deliberative session by David Lang to remove their annual dues, mm-hmm. which passed the deliberative session, but the budget failed, so it didn't matter. I wanted to bring the NHMA in to the budget committee to explain why we would not want to entertain defunding them subsequently. And they came in and explained who they were and all that sort of stuff. And the essence is that they are their primary function is a lobbying group. Of course, one of the functions of the lobbying group is to educate, right? And who they lobbying for is the governing body, namely the Board of Selectmen. Okay,
yeah.
So that's who they represent as a lobbying group. So anything that the town wants to do, more or less, has to be done with the blessing, either implicitly or explicitly, by the Board of Selectmen. Last year, from my understanding, the Board of Selectmen chose to change what was always implicit approval for requests for information to requiring explicit approval. Okay? And so that's where we are now. And I think that's where the friction is coming from, is that change from implicit to explicit. Mm-hmm. And it may be that we really need to have an understanding of exactly what the policy is and why the policy changed. Does it need to be this way? That kind of thing. As opposed to going after NHMA, because it's not NHMA's fault.
No.
Okay. Right. This is one of the issues, in my estimation, that needs to be dealt with, and there are several, including 91A. And I don't mean the 91A from the past, but I mean how we move forward with 91A properly in the future. These are issues that I previously mentioned that the chairman ought to sit down with the head of the town management, the head of the board of selectmen, and iron out common understanding on some of these main points, NHMA interface being one of those main points, 91A matters being another one, collecting information in general from town government is still another. There are actually several. I don't want to go in a new brain at all right now, but in my opinion, that's the only way to rationally approach the problem. Otherwise, we're going to sit here as a committee and say, okay, we want to get an understanding of how we go about getting that. So we're going to invite the chairman of the Board of Selectmen in here to explain why the policy is that way. Do we ask Regina to go out and get that explanation, and then we have questions to her, and she's going to go out and get answers to our new questions, and it's just going to go on forever. All right? It's really best that someone from the Budget Committee sit down with the personnel that I referred to and just iron all this stuff out, all right, and be done with it.
Okay, now, Sonny, go ahead.
Yeah, one other thing to throw on the table. Last year, the Board of Selectmen said we can't ask the department questions. We have to submit the questions beforehand.
Wait a minute. That's another whole issue.
I understand. That's the same.
Sonny, I know. If you want to talk about it.
I'm just laying it on the table.
That's okay.
Let me change the subject completely.
I know you kind of, but so perhaps we could just stick with the New Hampshire MA at the moment. So what, is there a motion here?
No, I just recited my campaign speech, didn't I?
Yeah. And Mr. Henderson, please go
ahead.
I'll
make it real brief. I know in the past, for 20 plus years, I was on the labor laws committee for the town, okay? And several other committees, as president of HPA and things like that. And I always had access to call the NHMA at will to get an answer while I was on these committees. I didn't have to go through the selectmen. I didn't have to jump through hoops. I didn't have to put letters together. I called up there. The town of Hampton, as Jenny says, pays $18,000 each year for access. So why shouldn't we have access to it? I think at least every elected official and every person that's involved in a board in this town, if they have a question, should be able to call up there and get the correct answer. You know, I don't think there should be any hoops jumping. We pay a lot of money to it. And I think, why not get our money's worth, you know?
Now, I think that up until recently, when I say recently, just the last couple of years, okay,
last year.
I think that it was, as you say, any elected person could call it New Hampshire MA. I don't know that for a fact. Okay,
I do. It was up until approximately June of last year that it went from implicit to explicit.
Okay. Perhaps this is something, Regina, that you could ask the Board of Selectmen. I do know that the Board of Selectmen, I believe that they control this, that we don't have the control. And that's the way it was, sort of been explained to me. We don't have the control over this. And as far as even getting the NHMA to come here and give us a training session, the town of Hampton gets one free training session. And the Board of Selectmen decides who's going to get that training. They could have, there was one year that they came down here, and every elected official was invited. And it was in this room. I don't know how many of you remember that from a few years ago. It was not that long ago, because I remember attending. That's what they chose to do. They could choose to have that. Or they could choose to allow them to come in to talk just to the Budget Committee. That's up to the selectmen. I would like to make a request that they allow them to come in here on our May meeting for some training for this budget committee. We don't have to come up with all of the questions at this meeting, we can do it at the think about it in the next meeting. We can have, if we have specific things that we'd like them to talk about, that's just my suggestion. So
similar to what we did last year.
Yes.
Steve, is that something new as far as one free training? Because I know the old days, you know, only a few years ago, we could request them to come up to our meetings that we had with the joint labor laws on any given time. They said they were always willing to come in and discuss and talk to us about whatever topics we're discussing. So therefore, is that a change?
When we called them in 3 years ago for them to explain themselves to the budget committee, they said that because of the enormity of the dues that the town of Hampton pays, that we're entitled to one free training. Other towns that don't pay such a large dues are not.
So and that's
a change then.
Yeah, and so 3 years ago when they came in here, they weren't here to train us. They were here to introduce themselves.
To explain themselves.
Right, right. And that was on the request of this board.
Committee.
Perhaps even Tim Jones made that motion. But that's what the explanation was at the time. So we, and as well, up until a couple of years ago, I believe we budgeted money in a line for some training.
It's still there.
$300, I think.
I think this may be the change that Jenny and Steve may not be plugging into, but NHMA come up with
$350 a person.
NHMA came up with a training session, which they hold up in Manchester and other parts of the state, three of them during the year, and you have to pay to go. And since they started using that as a revenue generator, they may have changed their policy regarding the free training.
Yeah, because I went to the newly elected officials last year out in Jaffrey's.
No, that was different. This is just for budgeting. There's a budgeting only.
They got them
session.
All over the place now.
There's three. No, they have newly elected ones. It's a totally different topic.
Okay. Tim, hold on just for a minute. And the way that it was working in this budget committee was that any newly elected person would be able to go to the training that year. And there was usually enough money in there for two people to go, I think.
That was a point of contention back then.
It was Tim and me.
Okay.
That was a point of contention back then. I was objecting to the chairman at the time that we should all have equal training. And, you know, back then I wasn't listened to by anyone. But subsequently, the next year, it was finally, you know, when we finally realized that we get one free and we've now been using it for all these years. Why not use it to educate everyone equally at the same time? And that's when this process that you are familiar with began.
That's a good point.
I have webinars.
I would like to mention, Sonny, that I didn't go. I was invited to go, but I didn't have time at that. I was still working or something. I don't remember. Whatever the reason was, I didn't have time to travel to Manchester and attend an all-day meeting. So Eileen went, and she brought back this book. And this book has everything in it you need to know. And I would like to perhaps, when they do come, and even if there's a cost for the book, because we have a little bit of money in training, and if this book is, you know, maybe we could get whoever would like a copy, okay?
They passed these out last year.
That's right.
They gave us these. This is the newest update.
When they came to the workshop.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, those.
So they brought these last year.
Okay. So we would like them to, of course, bring the latest update again, and then we'll all have it. Because if you take this and read it, I'm telling you right now, you're going to know everything you need to know about a budget committee in this state. Okay, so.
Well, wouldn't that, what you just said, answer our question? I assume it's in there based upon what you just said.
No. No, no.
We're going to know that if they came here to train us, they would have some different things that probably aren't in that book, right? Mr. Jones?
The problem that we've had, the NHMA training session had 2 years in a row. And each time we've tried to improve it. I mean, the first year they spent probably at least more than half of their time talking about their lobbying efforts. And the balance was spent on the budget process. And so last year we asked them to, you know, nix the lobbying presentation and just give us the budgeting process. And the hope was that that would afford time for questions. Problem came was that somehow they were instructed or decided that while they were happy to entertain questions, they would only do it with the cameras off. And so then that became an issue. And so if we bring them back, we need to probably be more specific and says we have to ask the selectmen for this. We're going to have to ask them, in my opinion, we have to ask them, can we have the seminar? And would you allow them to answer our questions on camera so the whole town can hear the questions and answers?
I don't think they'll do that online.
I think that it...
Well, why don't we...
My suggestion, I'm not suggesting that. I'm trying to avoid such suggestions, Regina. What I am suggesting is that the selectmen simply express that they are allowing it to happen. If the NHMA wants to reject that, that let them own it. Okay? But, you know, last year it was like, oh, maybe it was them or maybe it was those guys over there. But, I mean, we're going to need that. I mean, they're going to come in and answer questions, let us have questions. And they only allowed us questions for like 10 minutes. I think it was really ridiculous. Sure. It was the first year they came in, they spent close to 3 hours, you know, and, you know, slightly over 90 minutes of that were on their lobbying effort. So the next year we come in and they do the budget process in less than 90 minutes, and we get 10 minutes of questions off camera. There's something, you know, a little screwy with that.
Okay, well, I think that the chairman could take care of that. Yeah. And eventually they're going to have to get in contact with that chairman, and he can explain.
I agree. I'm just suggesting that you want to be...
No, I agree with you 100,000%. But I think that's something that he could deal with once we get it okay.
Okay. Sonny, is this about the New Hampshire MA?
Let me just throw something else out on the table, and then I'd like to make a motion to adjourn. I think it'd be a useful resource for the budget committee and the residents of the town if we set up a website, a blog, so that people can send questions in, we can explain positions.
That's a different topic, Mr. Chairman. Put it on the list that you can talk about later.
Okay, I'll put it on the list, Sonny. We can talk about it next time a little bit.
Now, the other part was the motion to adjourn.
Wait, okay. Before we adjourned, and we tried that before, but it's a good thing we didn't do it, because we've had all this lively discussion. Any other issues? Or what is the pleasure? Do you wish to make a motion regarding this New Hampshire MA, or do we just need a concession and have Regina take...
I have no motion. I'm just suggesting that if you're going down the road of that you were suggesting to ask Regina, to ask the Board of Selectmen for their approval to get NHM in here, we be a little more specific, that we would not just like them in here, we'd like them in here on camera, including a Q&A session, only on the budget process itself.
I agree, Tim, but I think that...
That's a suggestion.
Okay, I agree, but let's just see if we can get permission and get them in here for May, and then at our next meeting we can come up with a list of suggestions. And how does that sound, Regina?
That sounds good.
That sound all right? I mean, I don't think we need to go into that level of details with you. First, we have to find out if they're coming. Once we know that, we can decide.
You know, go to town hall, and then they're going to have to contact them.
Exactly.
Do we want them to come if they're not going to be on camera and not going to entertain questions on camera? Do we still want them to come?
I would say yes. Okay, and let's see if they're going to come. Then we can do our terms.
That's what I'm saying. We do it in one step. We may not get an answer to all of our questions until September, and then it'll be too late.
And we don't know all the... We don't have a list of all of the things we want to ask right now.
No, not the questions we're going to ask them about the budget process, but the conditions under which we would like them to be invited.
It would be nice if it was an open meeting. If there was a reason, some legal reason, that it cannot be, it has to be off camera. I don't know. I'm not a lawyer. The same thing goes with Mark Gerald at our next meeting, okay? He may have a reason. It might have to do with personnel. It might have to do with, I don't know. I don't know what reason they...
Excuse me, Mr. Chairman, we just had a motion on that topic.
I know we did.
And we were specific. We wanted on camera, including questions and answers.
I know. That's what we want.
No backing off from that. We as a committee decided that.
That's what we want.
So I'm hearing someone backstep. I don't like hearing that.
Okay. I'm not backstepping, but I'm not the lawyer. Bob?
Going into a broader topic, I heard some positivity in the room tonight about working collegially and cooperatively. I think if this committee should take anything away from the two votes concerning it in the last couple of 3 years, it's one, the community absolutely thought the committee was too large, and about half the community thought it should be discontinued. So I think we should not ignore that. Had 26 people
this
voted
is not topical.
Other than the way they did, this committee would no longer exist after the coming session. So I think we should kind of keep that in our mindset going forward.
And as well, this we have to work as a group, okay? Everybody can have an opinion. We can agree to disagree as well. We need to respect each other. We need to respect other boards, okay? So Sonny has his hand up.
Yeah. I had a question. Are you glad you got elected chair? Are you glad you got elected chair?
Yes, thank you very much, Sonny. I didn't realize it's going to have so much fun, but
Mr. Chairman.
Yes, sir.
I'd like to respond to Mr. Ladd's comment.
Okay, hold on the motion to adjourn, Sonny. Mr. Jones, go ahead and respond to Mr. Ladd's.
Mr. Ladd is numerically correct regarding the vote. It was a surprisingly small margin in which the Budget Committee was preserved beyond this year. Regardless of the vote, it was still going to be existing this year. However, the suggestion that we have to keep that in mind was a little bit disconcerting. I think what we need to keep in mind is that with the snowstorm and all and the somewhat suppressed vote, I know you like to think there's a 10-year average and it was normal and all that stuff.
I heard all that good stuff.
But there were people who would normally vote that didn't vote because of the storm. People I know personally. So it was somewhat suppressed. I'm not making a big deal out of it. The bottom line is, well, it only a slight majority kept the Budget Committee. That's a negative way of looking at it. Because the truth is, the majority voted to keep it. A majority voted to keep it. That's a fact. And you can look at it from a negative point of view.
This is a problem.
And you can look at it from a...
I think Bob's...
Mr. Chairman, may I continue uninterrupted, please?
Hold on. Shh. Please continue. Everybody else, just wait a minute, please. Go ahead. Continue.
And while you can look at it, whatever the number might have been, you can say, well, gee, it was a fearful experience, so we should be, you know, fearful in what we do. We should be so afraid that we should be afraid to act in any way that isn't in accord with those who have had the hatred toward us engendered into them by kangaroo courts. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Okay, that's fine. Okay, now everybody just take a deep breath.
I chose to be on this committee again for a reason, because I thought that we could be a great committee and work.
And we're going to be.
We could be, as long as you don't put a hammer over my head.
Well, listen, you're guilty until you're found innocent.
Not in my mind. This is America. You're innocent until proven guilty.
All right, hold on.
In a fair trial.
Hold on. Okay, everybody stop. Okay, I'd like to entertain a motion to adjourn. Would somebody make that motion?
Sonny made it.
Sonny, second by David. All those in favor of adjourning? Yeah. Thank you very much, Channel 22.